Welcome to today's coffee break. Today we're talking about utilizing the adjust cost slash price function. So basically what this is for is you can use it to do a mass update of your prices. So let's say that we know we want to raise all of our prices 10%, or maybe a specific vendor has given us a new price list and they've either increased or decreased their prices. Well, I certainly can go to each individual item or each individual stock keeping unit and change the pricing, but if there are a lot of items, I probably don't want to do that. And so there is a batch function available to help you do that process. So let's go ahead and open that up. It's in departments, financial management, inventory, and here you will see the adjust item costs and prices. So there are a couple of different options you have in here. First off, you have the option to adjust the item card if you're only using item cards, or the stock keeping unit. One thing I do want to caution you against is if you have stock keeping units, you'll want to adjust the item card first and then the stock keeping unit, so that just to be consistent with the data from the item card to the stock keeping unit. So let's go ahead and do an item card first. And then on the adjust field, you're selecting which field you want to adjust. So I can adjust the price, the profit percentage, the indirect cost, the last direct cost, or the standard cost. So in my case, I'm going to use the last direct cost. And now we have an adjustment factor. So a factor of 1 would be the same. You would end up with exactly the same last direct cost as before. So what we want to do is we want to basically say, you know, if there's a, let's say that they've rolled out a 10% increase, then you would do an adjustment factor of 1.1. If they reduced their pricing by 10%, then we would go 0.9, all right? So that's how the adjustment factor works. Then you have your rounding method. So we can round to the nearest 100, 10, thousands, or whole numbers. So I just choose whole numbers. You'll do what's appropriate for your company. And then you can select a range of items. You can select items with a specific vendor on them. You can select a specific inventory posting group. So whatever criteria you want to use to do this, in this case, this decrease by 10%, you can select filters on the item card to select certain items. So let's just open up an item card first. I'll show it to you. We'll run the process, and then we'll look back at it. Let's go to warehouse and planning. And let's bring up, let's see here, bring up one of our furniture items. All right, so this is a desk. I'm going to pull it up. And like I said, we're going to change the last direct cost. So looking down here, we see that the last direct cost was $900. So we'll go ahead and make sure that this is included in the batch where it would get decreased by 10%. Now, if I look down here on planning, pardon me, replenishment, I can see that I purchased this vendor from, or this item from this particular vendor. So I can filter on all the items for this vendor to bring them down 10%. So let me just escape out of here, and we'll just go back to the adjust. And on my vendor number filter, I'm going to enter the vendor from that item card. And now I just click OK. Actually, what do we have here? Adjustment factor, we'll do 9. And we're doing the item card. There we go. So I click OK. And that went really fast. If you're doing a bunch of items, you actually can see the process running. But if you just have a few, it can go really quickly. So let's go back to the warehouse and take a look at that item. And we see now that the last direct cost has been adjusted. It has been decreased by 10%. So minus $90, we now have $810. Okay. Let's look at another item that has a SKU. All right. We'll just take a look at that stock keeping unit. We have a blue location, so maybe we're doing it for a specific location. Take a look at that. And again, we have here the last direct cost. In this case, it's $31.70. So let's say that there is an increase. We could go back and we could just set it to the stock keeping unit level. So we'll go back to financial management, inventory, adjust costs and prices. And I'm going to change this to stock keeping unit. I'm going to keep it at last direct cost. And let's say there's an increase of 10%. I don't need my filter on my vendor anymore, but I want to do a location filter. So down here where it says limit totals to, I'm going to keep this location filter blue. Now I click OK. Again, it went really fast because there weren't that many. And I can go back to the warehouse and take a look at that item. And if I look at the stock keeping unit, I'll see that that has been changed. There we go. Our last direct cost is now 35. So it's a nice way to batch processes. You know, you might even do an entire batch and then go and change a few that are, you know, one-offs. Let's say a vendor gives you a new price list. Everything's increased by 10%, except for maybe a handful of items. Well, you could still run the batch process and then go to those individual item cards or stock keeping units and make the changes. That concludes our lesson on using the batch process to update your costs and your prices.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.